Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting video tutorial of Premiere Pro. And in this tutorial I will be teaching you about how to import your media. So we have already seen why we are importing media, and that was going to file and clicking on this import button, or just creating on Control R on the keyboard, and then import your media or take you to the folder where your media is, and then you can select and open it. Okay, now there are a few other options of importing it, and the first one is by going in your project pan to your media browser and then clicking on tilde key. Actually, I inside a folder which I want to import, but I don't want to go there. Okay, for example, you are in your R drive and you have the disk information. You can actually go to the folder where your media files are. For example, I want to go to this folder file and then bring in some sort of stuff or whatever that I want to use. And I'm going to bring in this client's picture. To import it, import this still image, I have to right click it and click on import, and then it will be brought to the project pan. This is for still image, and the same way I can do this for a video clip. I can right click and click on import, and then it will be brought. Let me bring in the sound wave also. So we have all the options. Now we will click that as well. Okay. Now, other thing that I want to show you is that the option that you had in the media browser that I showed you, which you can do with the source monitor and other places, you can scrub through and scrub preview is available. Also here, there in the media browser, you can also right click it and then it's a spacebar, or just drag it with your mouse and see the different places where your different parts of the media or the file that you are working on. Okay, so that's how you bring in the media from your through your media browser, and which is on your hard drive. Now you can also bring in media from card or media card or a camera card. It is totally possible, but there are two things that I want to mention. If you ever want to bring direct media from your camera card, the first thing is that whenever you want to bring in media and or files from a media card, always click on this button. This is the icon button, and see if the file format is one of these: After Effects, Project, Canon RAW, Cinema, DNG, RDD, Sony HDV, and stuff like this. If it is not one of these formats, then it's not gonna properly work in the Premiere Pro. If it is in these formats, then it will work in Premiere Pro. So if they are not, then what you should do is copy all those files to your computer, and in the converting software, whatever you use, first convert them to the proper format that is compatible with the Premiere Pro, and then bring them into your Premiere Pro project for editing or working with them. Also, it is also a really good idea to always bring media to your hard drive first, and then from here you can bring them back to your to Premiere Pro. Actually, I am forgetting the name of Premiere Pro so much this today that it's like I'm trying to remember something from the time of ancient Greek. Okay, so far so good. But you are not just limited to bringing media from hard drives or media cards or just video files and stuff. You can also bring in media from other project files. For example, this is the cache folder on my E drive, and then in here there is a Premiere Pro file, and then here is another project that I worked before on it. It was a video that I created. It came past the channel there. It's all YouTube channel Food for Thought if you want to check it out. Okay, for example, I want to bring this into it and then work on it. The same ways apply.
either have the option to open the project, or you can just click on the import and it will bring in the file. But if you click on the, or you try to import an existing or another project of Premiere Pro, it will not be imported just like the media or video or audio or simple still image item. This window will pop up and it asks me that whether I want to import the entire project or I want to import selected sequences. Now it depends on you. If you want to work on this project again, you want to import the entire project. But if you want to work on the sequences of this project in your current project, then you want to click on this import selected sequence. It depends on you. Since I'm not doing or working on any of them, so I'm gonna hit cancel and I would not import it. Okay, the last thing that I want to mention is that if you hit tilde key and go to the project pane and hit tilde key again, now the project pane is increased. Okay, you can really change it here also, but this is a very good way to see. Okay guys, once you come to the project pane and you full screen it by hitting tilde key, I want to show you, okay, talk about the media, different files of the media. Okay, the still image is shown or highlighted by this pink bar or, you know, mark in front of its name, and the file is shown like this. And the video file, which is video and audio, which is called actually the movie clip in Premiere Pro, is shown by this purple icon or mark. And just the sound clip, which is just add the audio, it is this, you know, green mark in front of it. Now these are for example just only three files, but suppose you are working with hundreds and dozens of files like this, it's a good idea to organize them into folders, and folders inside Premiere Pro are called bins. And now I will show you how to create bins or folders inside your project pane. Okay, you go to file and then go to new and then click on bin, or you can just click on Control B and then they will create one. Okay, now a bin is just a folder, but inside Premiere Pro the name is bin, so we have to roll with it what you can do with it. Okay, then you can name this whatever you want. Okay, for example, I want to name this one still images, and then inside this, once I've created it, I'm gonna click on my still image or the broken watches JPEG it is, and then bring it into my still image folder, and then it's inside now the still image folder. The same way we can create bins for our other folders. You know, this one I would say video clips, and then we will bring in all our video clips like this one into it, and so on. Okay, you can create as many as you want and organize your media the way you see fit. Okay, so far so good. Then I'm gonna tilde key and go back to the previous view. So that's it guys for importing medias. These are some of the ways that you can bring media into your, you know, Premiere Pro project for editing. Okay, I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.